Hi guys, I watched The Space Between and I really enjoyed it. I mean, it's the kind of movie that touches your feelings. It's the type that gives you that good feeling. It's like it makes the connection between the movie, the characters, and the audience. It's about awakening a legend. Mickey Adams represents a generation of musicians, those whose works were original, genuine, and profound in meaning. He started in 1960s, very soon became a legend, but in 1975, he just disappeared from the world of music. Why? Well, according to himself, he lost his muse. What was that? The answer is hidden in his latest album, Doors.
What is that? It's a coffin.
Doors symbolizes leaving. Imagine the slam of a door behind someone dear leaving. Now, imagine that door to be a coffin door. I mean, he finds meaning in his recordings and defends his recording of Doors.
Nothing more evocative than the sound of doors.
So that can't be meaningless to him. I mean, the coffin is a reminder of his wife's death. We can assume that's when he lost his muse and suddenly couldn't even play anymore. After that, he breaks. He's not crazy, but he just has a different view of the world. He has a deep understanding of the world. He hears the songs that the world sings. But now, he's broken inside, because he has lost it all together. His muse, his wife, his music, and now even his daughter. She doesn't even consider him her father. Now he's looking for inspiration and is trying everything. The wind, the water, the waves, the llama, the birds, drugs, I mean everything. But something is missing here. His fabulous definition of music is that when you yearn for something, someone, so bad and never quite getting it, music is that space between. That space, I think, causes a lot of pain. He's been looking for something or somebody. In the scene when Mickey finds Charlie at the piano and is able to play again after about 20 years, he thinks Charlie is the reason. But in fact, it's the memory of his wife and Julia that drives him. This mistaken muse is why he can't perform the night at the bar. But then comes the ocean talk. Charlie mentions Julia, and that's the moment of Mickey's epiphany. Julia, as if it is the first time he realizes her, she has always been there and he has never seen her. That's the moment he finds his muse. But before that, he symbolically dies in the ocean and revives again a new Mickey Adams, with a new space between him and Julia. This time, he sings at the bar. The first song he can perform completely is J for Julia. Okay, that was Mickey's evolution. But before we finish this video, this scene is magical. If you didn't get tears in your eyes when you watched it, you haven't understood Mickey properly. Well, thanks for watching my video. Please like, subscribe, and push that little bell button to be notified of my next video. Don't hesitate to leave a comment if you have anything on your mind.